So good morning. So in previous lecture we have discussed different types of looping statements and its syntax and a program example to display 1 to 10 numbers using different looping statements. In this lecture we shall see some of the implementation using looping statements. So the first implementation concept I am going to discuss is display the message BLDCT Vijaipur 20 times on the screen. Second, we shall see the implementation for sum of natural numbers between 1 to 10, sum of even numbers between 1 to 10, sum of odd numbers between 1 to 10, sum of even and odd numbers between 1 to 10. So this is an assignment for you. And finally, we shall discuss display the numbers divisible by both 3 and 6. The number should be between 1 to 30. Also, we shall display the count of numbers. So, total how many numbers which are divisible by both 3 and 6. Let us see one by one the implementation. So, the first one is display the following string BLDCT Vijaipur 20 times. So here the statement will be same. So the statement is of type string data type, and we have to repeat the operation of displaying 20 times. This can be performed in two ways. The first way is using printf statement with the string BLDCET Vijaipur and writing 20 times the same printf statement. This can be achieved. And another way is, instead of writing 20 times the same statement, printf with the message, we shall write only one time and we can enclose the printf statement inside a while loop, any one type of the while loop. So we may use a for loop, do while loop, or even we can also use just while loop. So let us implement a code for displaying this BLDCET Vijaipur message 20 times on the screen. So let us open the terminal. So in a terminal, type gedit, give a name of the file, say display dot c, so go to gedit. So here the file has been opened. So write a program. The first statement is inclusion of file stdio.h void main. So it doesn't require any variable declaration. Say directly use while loop. We have to declare a variable for incrementing purpose. So let us declare int I and initialize it to 1. So now you write while loop and check the condition until 20 times. The value of I should be what here, less than 20 times. If this condition is satisfied, what operation has to be done? So I want to display the message, that is printf BLDEA CET VIJYAPUR Jaipur / n double quote semicolon. So close the flower bracket and close the main function flower bracket. And after writing this program, save the file and go to the terminal. Compile the program, cc display dot c. Write a correct file name, cc display dot c. The program is correct. Continue the execution, .a.out. See, this is output. So it went into the infinite loop. So let us increment I equal to, so I plus plus. So again save the file, run the program, recompile the program and execute using .a.out. See, 20 times it has been displayed. So here what happens, initially the value of I is 1, so 1 is less than 20, the condition is satisfied, it will enter into the loop and this message will be displayed first time. Next, what happens, the content of I is incremented by 1 and again it will go back to the condition, that is while the value of I is 2 less than 20, again this condition is satisfied, the second time this message is displayed on the screen. So this process will be repeated until the value of I is less than or equal to 20. Whenever the value of I is 21, then this condition will be failed and the control will come out from the loop. This is a program which shows how to display the particular string on the screen 20 times. See, if I am not using the while loop or any other looping constructs, so we need to write 20 times the printf statement. So here the redundance of the data will be repeated here. So same statement we will write it 20 times, but here with the help of loop, a same statement have written only 1 times, but the operation will be repeated 20 times. This is the advantage of using a looping statement. So let us see second concept, implementation of second concept. The second concept is develop a C program to display the sum of natural numbers between 1 to 10, and we have to display the sum finally on the screen. So let us consider this is our input and the output has to be generated in this form. The sum of natural numbers between 1 to 10 is 55. So here The requirement for implementation of this program is we need to have a some variable. So this is one time initialization, and this is used to store the sum computed for the 10 natural numbers. And we need to have one more variable, and it is initialized to 0. So it acts as a counter so that each time to access the next natural number. So this operation is repeated 10 times and used to perform the addition with the previous value. And this is a condition statement we use inside the looping statement to check the condition. If this condition is satisfied, then we will continue for adding a number with the previous one. So all these are what here the required variables for implementation of the program. So let us write a program to compute the sum of natural numbers between 1 to 10 and display the result on the screen. So open the terminal. The program is gedit sum.c. The program has been opened here. See here, we are declaring two variables. The first one is I, and second one is what here? Sum. The I is initialized to, so we are using for loop here. So the syntax of for loop is first initialization part, second part is condition, and third part is either increment or decrement operation. So here what we are doing, the I value is initialized to 1, and the I value is verified here. So that is 1 is less than or equal to 10. Yes, the condition is satisfied. The control will enter into the loop. So in a loop, what will happen? The sum of natural numbers will be performed here. So present value of sum is 0. 0 plus the I value is 1. So 0 plus 1 is 1, and that 1 is stored in sum variable. Now the sum value is what here? 1. So once after this operation is performed, it will go back to the loop, and the value of I will be incremented by 1. So now the value of I is 2. 2 is less than 10. Yes, the condition is satisfied. Again, the control will enter into the loop. Now the sum, old value of sum is 1 and present value of I is 2. So 1 plus 2 is 3, and that 3 will be stored in sum. Means the sum variable will be updated with the new value, that is 3. Again, it will go back to the looping statement. The value of I is incremented by 1. So this process will be continued until the value of I is less than or equal to 10. So whenever the value of I is 11, so the 11 is not neither less nor equal to 10, then it will come out from the loop. So the sum will be having the sum of the natural numbers between 1 to 10, and finally we are displaying the content of sum on the screen. So let us execute this program. Go to the terminal, cc sum dot c. The program is not having any error, so continue the execution. Dot slash a dot out. Yes, the output is the sum of natural number between 1 to 10 is 55. So now we'll see the next concept, that is develop a C program to sum even numbers between 1 to 10 and display the sum on the screen. So the concept is there are only 5 even numbers between 1 to 10. So we have to add only those even numbers. So which are even? So this concept can be implemented by using modulus operator, and if the remainder is equal to 0, then that number is said to be even, and only that number will be added for the previous value. So as usual, we have some variable, we will be having I variable, and we declare one more variable remainder. So these operations will be repeated 10 times, and this is a condition. If this condition is satisfied, then we will perform the addition operation. So here we choose only even numbers for the addition. So we decide the number is even or odd by using the modulus operator. Okay, so let us implement this program. Here modify the same program. If so let us find out remainder equal to I modulus set to, so we need to declare the variable R. So if R equal to 0, if R equal to 0, then we perform the addition, otherwise we don't perform the addition. Okay, so the initial value of I is 1. 1 is less than 10, the condition is true here. Then the control will enter into the loop. So here the modulus operation will be applied for 1. So if remainder is equal to 0, then that number is what here? The even. Otherwise it's a yes. So here the remainder is equal to 0. If the remainder is equal to 0, then only we will consider that number for addition. Otherwise that number is odd and we will leave it. So this process will be continued until the value of I is less than or equal to 10, till I value is less than or equal to 10. So finally we will display the content of sum. So the sum variable will be having the sum of the even numbers only. So let us execute this program. So once again the name of the program is sum.c. compile the program, continue the execution. So the result is not correct here. So the sum of just a minute. So I value remainder, if remainder equal to 0, then sum equal to sum plus a. Could equal to sum equal to sum plus I. Again it will go back, I value will be displayed. So 2 modulus 2 is 0. If r equal to 0, so if remainder equal to 0, yes, say once again. Compile the program. Yes, the result is 30. So once again see the output. Compile the program. See the result is 30. So now let us implement next concept. Develop a C program to sum odd numbers between 1 to 10 and display the sum on the screen. So here it's a reverse order. So if the number is even, then we will not consider. If the number is odd, then we will consider it for the addition. So let us modify the same program. So here if the number, so when the number will be even, if the remainder is 0, so just change the condition here. If r not equal to 0, then perform the addition. So here the sum of even number, sum of, sorry, odd number, numbers between 1 to 10 is sum. So the value of I is 1, I is less than 10, I plus plus. So I value is 1, 1 is less than 10, condition is satisfied. The control will enter into the loop. So here remainder will be present in R. So we check the condition. If remainder is not equal to 0, then we perform the addition. So if the remainder is not equal to 0, then the number is what here? Odd. Only those numbers will be considered for the addition. So let us save this program. Once again re-execute, go to the terminal, clear the screen, compile the program and continue with the execution. So the sum of odd numbers is 25. Suppose if I asked you to display the sum of the odd numbers between 1 to 50, then you need to change just the condition here. So make it as a 50. Suppose if I ask you to find the sum of odd numbers between 1 to 100, then you just write here 100. Say recompile this. So 2500. So let us see next concept. Develop a C program to find the sum of even and odd numbers between 1 to 10. So in this case you have to display both even sum, even numbers sum between 1 to 10, as well as odd numbers sum between 1 to 10. So this can be implemented by using if else here. So if else the number is what here, the number is even here, sum even equal to sum even plus I. So this is sum odd equal to sum odd plus I. So declare two variables, sum odd equal to 0, sum even equal to 0, comma remainder. So two printf statement. So this is for sum odd and this is for sum even. So we have declared two variables. So this variable will hold the sum of the odd numbers. This variable will hold the sum of even numbers. So for loop, so here I is initialized to 1, and we want to find the sum of odd and even between 10. That's why we have written in conditional statement, we have written 10, and every time I will be incremented by 1. So initially we will find a remainder. So if the remainder is not equal to 0, then that number is nothing but I value is 1, that number is odd, so this particular statement will be executed. Okay, again it will go back. Now the value of I is 2, 2 is less than or equal to 10, this condition is satisfied. It will enter into the loop again, new remainder will be computed. So if remainder is not equal to 0, but here the remainder is equal to 0, then what happens, this particular if block will be skipped and the control will enter to the else block, and it will find the sum of even numbers, and finally this sum of even number variable will be having the sum of even numbers between 1 to 10. This variable will be having sum of odd numbers between 1 to 10. Finally we are displaying the content of sum of odd and sum of even. So let us save this program and execute. Sum odd, there is a mistake in variable declaration. Sum odd, this must be double DD. Save the program. One more bracket is expected. Here save the program. The sum of odd is 25, the sum of even is 30. Thank you.